cinephiles, film enthusiasts, and relaxation seekers. My name is Cinephile ASMR, and in today's video, we talk about the Night House. So the Night House is probably a title that many, if not most, of you haven't even heard of, and I'm here to put it on your radar because I think it is something that you really need to check out. But what is the Night House about anyway? This film follows a recent widow as she essentially tries to uncover the reasoning and impetus for her late husband's passing, and in doing so, she begins to unravel an entire mystery and a world that encompasses her that she won't be able to return from. Now, I'm trying to be as vague as possible in my description of this because when I went into it, I knew nothing, literally nothing aside from the director behind it. And I'm glad I did so, because as blind as you can go into this, the better off I think you will be. But at the same time, this movie requires patience, and I believe that is something that a lot of films, especially within the horror genre, is failing, is that they forget to treat their audiences like adults and realize that we require patience in a lot of ways. This current horror landscape has been polluted with jump scares and quick time, fast reactions with the sound and the visual, which is obviously going to get a rise out of you, but the Night House knows better than that. This movie really requires you to be like a fly on the wall and experience everything that Rebecca Hall's character does every step of the way, and in doing so, you are inadvertently becoming sucked in to not only her perspective, but the way that she feels and how the world around her descends into this madness, and you're along the ride every step of the way. Now, how is Rebecca Hall in this? Absolutely exhilarating. She is one of the most underutilized talents in film and in art, period. Every movie she's in, whether it's a minor role or a titular role that is only set for her, feels as if she was born for it, and this movie might quite possibly be her best. It is to depths that I haven't seen very many horror films go. This is a very human story that at its core deals with very real, honest, lively, emotional beats. And if you go into this expecting a very paranormal film, you will get that to an extent, but I promise you this ending will disappoint. I'm not going to spoil it, but when I say that it starts off in a way and then it descends into many different aspects to then culminate into something that I had to sit on and digest instead of immediately just reacting, it doesn't go out with a bang. It isn't like Paranormal Activity where it just builds and then boom. It is like a soft fizzle, but it ignites slowly, and when you let it completely overtake you, I think that's when you'll gain the full effect. David Bruckner, the filmmaker behind this, has had a track record of telling stories that at first glance and on paper can feel very inhuman and supernatural, but when you dive to the meat of it all, you can tell that he has a knack for loving the human side to it all. And to me, I'm not sure for you guys, but the scariest things are the ones that you can see, that you can feel: grief, anger, sadness, pain. And when that can be manifested into things, the landscape for how to scare an audience is limitless. And this movie really does get into that, and it does this juggling act, and not every bit works, but I think at the